Hello students, hope your concepts of chapter 8 motion are clear. Hope you have done the theory part and practice the numericals also. So in this video, we are going to practice some MCQs of chapter 8 motion. So let us see, our first MCQ today is, from the given graph, it can be inferred that the object is, you can have a look at the graph. Graph, first of all, see that it is labeled as VT. It means it is a VT graph. So it may be a speed time or velocity time graph, but unless specified, we'll assume that the body is moving along a straight line. So from the given graph, what do we infer? We see that V value remains constant throughout, as when time passes, V value remains constant. So this graph, which is a straight line parallel to time in time axis, indicates that V value does not change, which means that the body is in uniform motion, because we know that in uniform motion speed remains constant. So our correct option is B here. So you have to look at the four options and choose the correct one. Now the second MCQ is, a particle is moving in a circular path. The displacement after a half circle would be, there are four options given, 0, pi r, 2r, 2 pi r. Let us have a look at the diagram. It is a circle having diameter AB and which is having radius small r. We know that as a particle moves along a circular path and it covers half a circle, let us say A is the initial position of the particle. Then after completing half circle, its final position will be B, which is a diametrically opposite point. So displacement, as you know the definition, it is the shortest distance from initial position to the final position. It means in this case, shortest distance is the diameter AB, that is 2R. So from the four options, we'll choose 2R, that is C option is correct. I hope you have understood this. Next, third is, which of the following can sometimes be zero for a moving body? Which of the following can sometimes be zero for a moving body? There are four options given. Displacement, distance, both A and B, that is both displacement and distance, none of the above. Now, you know that whenever body is in motion, its distance can never be zero. Displacement can be zero because displacement is the shortest distance from the initial position to the final position. So when initial final positions are same, displacement is zero. Distance can never be zero. So obviously our correct answer is displacement, A option. Now let us see the fourth MCQ. It is based on this diagram. This is a graph, ST graph. We can have a look at the graph. This is ST graph, and we can see there are four curves drawn for ST graph, and A, B, C, D it is written. Let us read the question now. Four cars A, B, C, and D are moving on a leveled straight road. The distance time graph are shown in the figure below. It means this graph represents, it is actually four, on one single graph, there are four curves. So it means we can see the graphs of four cars here, right? You have to choose a correct statement. Car A is faster than car D, car B is the slowest, car C is faster than car D, car C is the slowest. Now, if you look at the graph, first of all, it is ST graph. Okay, ST graph for four different cars, A, B, C and D. Now we know that slope of ST graph or gradient of ST graph gives us what? It gives us speed of the body. So in this case, slope of the graph will give us speed of the car. As we see here, which car is having maximum slope? It means if we consider the same time interval, which is covering maximum distance, we can easily see that if time is taken constant, then D is having the maximum distance covered. So we can have a look at the graph, we can compare their slopes, it means we can compare their speeds. So now let us have a look at the option. What is first? Car A is faster than car D. Car A is faster than car D. No, car A has smaller slope. Its slope is less than that D. So first option is wrong. Car B is the slowest. Car B is the slowest. Yes. We know that car B has the least slope. It means slope is least, but slope of ST graph gives us what? Speed. So slope of ST graph for car B is minimum. It means that its speed is minimum. So car B is the slowest. Car B is the slowest. So B is the correct option. And let us have a look at the other options also. Car C is faster than car D. Car C, no. Car C is slower than car D because it is having less slope than car D. Last is car C is the slowest. As we have already seen here, car B is the slowest. So we know that B is the correct option. That is, car B is the slowest. Now let us have a look at the fifth MCQ. Now fifth MCQ's velocity time graph of a ball of mass 50 gram. So what is the mass of the ball? 50 gram. And this is a graph, VT graph for that ball. Okay. So velocity time graph of a ball of mass 50 gram rolling on a concrete floor is shown in the figure. What will be the frictional force of the floor on the ball? Now we know that this is a VT graph, right? So we can see that initially V stands for speed. So initially speed of the ball is 80 meter per second, and at last, finally, after 8 seconds, the speed becomes 0 meter per second. It means ball comes to rest. And we know the reason why ball comes to rest, because of the frictional force acting on it in a direction opposite to the direction of motion of the ball. So frictional force is responsible for this change in velocity, or for this retardation produced. So frictional force, we know the formula from Newton's second law, F is equal to ma. Mass is 50 gram. Acceleration. Now we know that slope of VT graph gives acceleration. So VT graph, what is the slope here? So from the graph, we see that we know that slope is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Or in this case, we can say perpendicular upon base. When we see the triangle formed on this graph, we can take perpendicular upon base gives us slope. It means 80 divided by 8, 80 meter per second divided by 8 second. Okay, so this is our slope, which is nothing but acceleration. So acceleration of VT graph is slope, which is here minus 10 meter per second square minus, we know this is a negative slope as the velocity is decreasing. Okay. So here you should put minus. Now F is equal to ma, mass 50 gram, just convert it into kg by dividing it by 1000 into 10. I have just taken the magnitude of this acceleration, 10. So when we do the calculation, we get F to be equal to 0.5 Newton. So force which is responsible for the retardation of this ball is 0.5 Newton. And here we have four options. What will be the frictional force of the floor on the ball? Out of four options, we can see 0.5 Newton is A option. So A option is correct. Now, next MCQ. The inertia of a moving body depends, moving object depends on. There are four options. Four things given here. Mass of the object, speed of the object, momentum of the object, and shape of the object. Now, you have to choose the correct option from A, B, C, and D. You have to choose a correct option. What is A? 1 and 2. It means the inertia of a moving object depends upon mass as well as speed. We know it is wrong. It only depends upon mass of the object. Remember, inertia depends upon only mass of the object. So out of these four options, A, B, C, D, B is the option which has only one. Only one means inertia depends only on mass. So B is the correct option here. I hope you have understood these MCQs. We'll continue now. Let us see the next MCQ.